This is such a rich parsha. The parshiot, I talk about parsha, this is the Torah portion. This is the section of Torah that we read corresponding to this week, so that we read through the whole Torah over the course of a year and then rewind back to the beginning. This week we're in the book of Exodus. Ki Tisa has a whole lot of just beautiful themes and stories. Georgie's going to cover much of it in her speech, but I do want to lift up this one piece that I think is really interesting. There's a moment where Moses, who has led the people through the liberation, the Exodus, Yetziat Mitzrayim, leaving Egypt, and has dealt with them through all of these trials in the desert and all kinds of difficulties, some of which Georgie's going to tell us about today. There's a section where Moses says to God, "Let me see you. I want to know who you are, God. This God that has delivered us from Egypt with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, with all of those miracles. God, I want to see you. I want to know your ways." What God says is curious. God says, "So I'm going to hide you behind this rock, and I'm going to pass before you. I'm going to shelter you with my hand, and then I'm going to turn around. I'll take my hand away, and you'll see my back. For no living human person can see my face and live." It's a really strange piece. What does this mean? The hand of God, the face of God, what are these things? The rabbis, as you can imagine, over the last 2,000 years of Jewish tradition, just have a field day with this piece because it's so rich and yet it's so vague. So, one piece that we get from Nachmanides, he says that God actually has a face and hands, that we are made B'Tselem Elohim in the image of God. There is actually a face of God that you could perceive. Maimonides, the famous Rambam, says, "That's crazy. God doesn't have human facial features or anything like that. You can't think of God in that way." That God's presence that we hear about here, that what Moses is looking for is an intellectual understanding of what God means, some kind of way to rationalize and perceive God, that this is all intellectual in nature, this presence of God, the face of God. It's shorthand for some kind of an understanding. What I think is really cool is what Ibn Ezra, rabbi from the 1400s, said. He said that this presence of God that we hear in this parsha, it's not something that you see or that you necessarily rationalize or can make sense of. Ibn Ezra says it's almost like light, that you can feel the light on your skin. You can perceive the warmth of light, even if you can't see an individual ray of light. I see the rays of light blinding our poor bat mitzvah right here. Very much of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Blessed Holy One, in this room with us celebrating. I think that there's something about that that makes sense. It's this idea that it's not something necessarily that you rationalize, but that you can perceive. You can find holiness, fleeting glimpses in this world. The rabbis tell us elsewhere in Talmud that we should find and say 100 blessings per day. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, etc., etc. Thank you, Cantor. That I want to suggest, though, that it's not about 100 actual recitations of that formula, but it's about finding these fleeting glimpses of blessing in our own lives, of being aware of all the ways in which we are blessed, whether it is a sunset, a glimmer of light, the smile on someone's face who you love. There are all manner of blessings that we can attach to, we can relate to, we can connect to. This parsha about the face of God and the hand of God, the strangeness of that, and the ambiguity, I really think is an invitation just to connect to whatever these glimpses, these moments, these hints of what is holy in your life, being aware of the things that are beautiful and that bring us blessing in our own journeys. This is the message of the hand and the face of God, and getting to perceive that which is holy.
Amen. Amen.